onset of clinical signs will be nearly immediate after the administration of physostigmine. Dramatic drop in heart rate will occur, but it will be brief. Onset of muscular fasciculations will make the heart rapidly rise again. This whole incident will occur in a matter of seconds. At this point, you'll start to see clinical signs of a cholinergic crisis. Profuse salivation, beyond that induced by ketamine anesthesia, can be observed around the mouth. Pupil size also will change. Increased pulmonary resistance using the ambu bag can be observed. Sweating on the palms and the soles of the feet will also be observed. Note increased muscle tone in the abdomen, as well as the rear legs and the tail. Atropine sulfate at a dose of 0.2 milligrams per kilogram in a pre-measured syringe is injected into the vascular line without recapping the needle. Temporary cessation of manual ventilation will allow the student to observe the atropine-induced reversal of the muscarinic clinical signs of the cholinergic crisis. Ventilatory assistance must be provided to supplement the respiratory efforts made by the animal until the animal's own respirations can maintain normal tissue oxygenation. Observations of the recovery must be noted and recorded on the animal health sheet. Observations of the recovery period include increased heart rate and character, or tachycardia, respiratory rate increasing to normal, decreased respiratory resistance, a decrease in oral secretions. However, muscle fasciculations may persist due to atropine affecting only muscarinic receptors. Additional atropine may be given as needed for the reversal of muscarinic signs at 10-minute intervals. Diazepam will be provided in the event that any animal experiences seizure activity. When all the students have had the opportunity to observe the continuum of clinical signs of the cholinergic crisis and treatment, the animal will be stabilized by veterinary staff until complete recovery, which usually takes approximately 90 minutes.